Hello friends, so as you can see from the video, today I am going to tell you the basic information about what are binary search trees. I will also be taking an example as to how a binary search tree can be constructed from a given set of data. But before moving on to binary search trees, we'll first need to understand what is a binary tree. You can pause the video and take a screenshot as and when you want. So, a binary tree is a data structure that is defined as a collection of elements called nodes. In a binary tree, the topmost element is called the root node. Each node has either 0, 1, or at the most 2 children. A node that has 0 children is called a leaf node or a terminal node. So, the left image is an example of a binary tree, and the right image shows the levels in a binary tree. The root node in a binary tree is always at the level 0. The children of the root node at level 1, their children at level 2, and so on. The levels in a binary tree can be extended up to infinite levels, as there are no such limitations on the construction of a binary tree and no such limitation as to how many levels the binary tree can have. Now, what is a complete binary tree? A complete binary tree satisfies two properties. First, in a complete binary tree, every level except possibly the last is completely filled. This means, taking the example of the image shown alongside, as you can see, every level except the last level has the maximum number of children, that is, every level has at the most 2 children. Second, all nodes appear as far left as possible. As you can see, the last level in the binary tree has almost 6 children, and all the children are towards the left of the binary tree. Now, moving on to binary search tree. You can take a screenshot if you want. So, a binary search tree, also known as an ordered binary tree, in which the nodes are arranged in an order. All the nodes in the left subtree have a value less than that of the root node. This means all the nodes that are in the left subtree have a value less than the value of the root node. Correspondingly, all the nodes in the right subtree have a value either equal to or greater than the root node. That means all the nodes in the right subtree will always have values either equal to or greater than the root node. Do remember, the same rule is applicable to every subtree of the binary search tree. So this is an example of a binary search tree, and as you can see, each element towards the right of the root node has a value less than the root node, and every element towards the right of the root node has a value greater than the root node. For example, as you can see, 39 is the root node, so all the nodes to the left of the 39 have value less than 39. Also, all the nodes to the right of 39 have value greater than 39. This is a major property of a binary search tree, and while constructing a binary search tree, you need to always remember this property. Now, the example which begins next will help you understand better the construction of a binary search tree using a given set of data. Now, we will be creating a binary search tree using the following set of numbers. As you can see on the video, the numbers are 58, 65, 13, 52, 28, 62, 2, and 8. Now always remember, the first element or the first number given in a set of data will always be the root node of the binary search tree. So now we begin with the first number 58. Now placing the first number 58 in the binary search tree will give us our root element or the root node. So 58 will be our root node for the binary search tree. Next in the list, we have the number 65. So as I had stated earlier, since 65 is greater than the root node 58, it will be placed in the right subtree of 58. So as you can see, we have placed 65 to the right of 58. Next, we have 13. Also, as I had stated earlier, the elements or the numbers or the data less than the root node will always be placed in the left subtree. So As you can see, 13 has a value less than 58, which is the root node. It will be placed in the left subtree. Next, we have in the list 52. So, since as you can see, the level 1 of the binary search tree has been completed, we'll start placing the elements in the next level. Always remember, each level in any tree, be it binary tree or a binary search tree, can have at the most 2 children. If the number of children in a particular level has been completed, you can start placing the children in the next level. So as you can see, the first level already has 2 children. We'll start placing children from the next level. So since we have the next number as 52, and 52 is lesser than the root node, we'll place 52 towards the left of 58. However, do remember that 52 has a value greater than 13, so it will be placed to the right subtree of 13. So basically, 52 will be in the left subtree considering the root element, but in the right subtree considering the child element 13. Next, we have the root element as 28. So as you can see, 28 is less than 58, which is the root node, but it is greater than 13. However, we have 52 as the child of 13, so we'll need to place 28 in the next level or as a child of the node 52. But 28, since being less than 52, needs to be placed in the left subtree of 52. So as you can see, we have placed 28 to the left subtree of 52. Next, we have the number 62. So as you can see, 62 is greater than the root node 58, but we already have a child node 65 in the right subtree of 58. So comparing it with 62, we notice that 62 has a value less than 65. So 62 will be placed in the left subtree of 65. Next, we have the number 2. So as you can see, 2 is less than 58, so it will be placed in the left subtree. We already have 13 as the child node of the root node 58, so again considering 13, 2 is lesser than 13, so 2 will be placed in the left subtree of 13. So as you can see, we have placed 2 as the left child of 13. Lastly, we have the number 8. So as you can see, 8 is smaller than 58, so it will be moved to the left subtree. We already have 13, but 8 is again less than 13, so it will be placed in the left subtree. But as you can see, in the left subtree, we already have 2 as the child node of 13. So we'll need to move 8 to the next level. So as you can see, the value of 8 is greater than 2, so it will need to be placed in the right subtree of 2. So as you can see, we have placed 8 as a right child node of 2, and this finally completes a binary search tree. Also, as I've pointed out, 58 will always be the root node, and so this is how a binary search tree needs to be completed or needs to be constructed using a given set of data. Now, before concluding this video, I have few important points to remember. You can take a screenshot of the same if you want. Always remember, a binary search tree always starts with a root node. The root node will always be the first element in a given list of elements, as I've stated earlier. Now, the two most important points. Do remember, all the elements smaller than the root should be placed to the left of the root node. And as I've shown in the previous example, this applies to every subtree of the binary search tree. All the elements greater than the root node should be placed to the right of the root node. This also applies to every subtree, as I've shown earlier. So thank you. Please do like, share and subscribe if you have enjoyed watching the video. Also, if you do have any questions, you can post it as comments and I'll reply to the same.